Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to configure return policies in Google Merchant Center. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. To create a return policy, go to your Google Merchant Center. Click on this icon and click on Shipping and Return under Tools. Once you have done that, click on the Return Policies tab. Now here, you'll be asked to create a new return policy. Click on the Add Policy button. Now they're going to present to you with the list of countries you want to make the return policies for. For us, I'm going to choose the United States, keeping it consistent with my feed. Let's go United States and click Next. Now here, they're asking for the link of the return policy page in your site. So let's go back to my site and quickly find this. I'll quickly jump onto my site. This is my refund policy page. I'll copy the URL, come back to Google and paste it here. There we go. Now it's asking us if we accept return from these countries. I'm going to say yes, I do accept returns. If you want, you can choose no if you don't wish to accept any returns from these countries. Click on Next. Now it's asking you how the customer can return your products. If needed, you can choose multiple options here. But for now, I'm just going to choose in-store because I only want my customer to return the products in-store. Let's go hit Next. Now it's asking you how much time the customers have to return the products. If you want, you can choose a lifetime guarantee, which means it does not matter how long before the customer have purchased your product. At any time, if they wish to, they can return the product because they have a lifetime guarantee. But for me, I don't want them to have a lifetime guarantee. I'll choose number of days. And let's say I'll put in 14 days. So I'm giving my customer 2 weeks to basically return the product. Let's go and hit Next. Now it's asking you what condition you'd allow returns. I'm going to choose new because I don't want used products to be coming back to our store. Let's go and hit Next. Now I'll keep the currency at USD, keeping it consistent with our feed. Now they're asking you if you're gonna charge them a restocking fee. I'll say no, I'll not charge them a restocking fee. If you want, you can charge them a certain amount or a percentage of the product price. Now here they're asking you how much the customer will pay for the return shipping. If you want, you can choose no cost, fixed cost, or the actual cost of the return shipping. Let's say I'm going to use a fixed cost and I'm going to charge them $5 for the return shipping. And this option is customer remorse. If the customer has purchased the wrong product or if it doesn't fit or if they no longer want the item, then if you want, you can charge them no cost when returning it, a fixed cost or the actual cost of shipping. So for my case, let's say I'm going to charge them a small fixed cost and let's make it $2. Let's go hit Next. There we go. Now this is the page of all the summary of your return policy. It's in United States. You've got the URL from our website. We accept returns. Return method is in-store. We've got 14 days. We want them new. No restocking fee. And these are the return reasons and their fees. So let's go ahead and hit done. Voila, there we go. Now your return policy is set. As you can see your return policies right here. This return policy that we have created is for a single country. Similarly, if you want, you can create return policies for multiple countries. All you have to do is select multiple countries on the first page when you're making your return policy. And the process you'll go through for creating that return policy is the same as when you're creating it for a single country. For now, I'll just go back and we'll discuss a little bit more about our single country policy. The policy that we have created here is applicable for all our products in our Google Merchant Center. If you want, you can add exceptions for certain products. So let's go ahead and hit that and see what it looks like. You have all the similar return policy options that you generally do, and plus on top of that, you can add a label which allow you to assign exception to specific products in your feed. So let's go back to our site and use CTX feed to configure some of these labels. If we do a little bit of research in our Google Merchant Center, we'll find out that this is the attribute we need to add to our feed, which is return policy label. Let's have a quick read. This is what the XML feed looks like. Brilliant. It looks relatively straightforward. So let's go back to our site and create a dynamic attribute to give us different return labels. So let's come down here. Let's click on dynamic attribute and create a new one. Let's go add new. Let's give this attribute name. Name this return labels. Cool. Let's add a few conditions. Let's say when the product category is equal to underwear, return the value no return. Cool, because we obviously don't want underwears to be returned back to our store. Let's go add another one. Let's say once again, when the product category is equals to shoes, return the value quick return, because we want this returned faster than our usual return time. Okay, for default values, let's say we'll keep it as empty. When you keep this value as empty, there's no return label assigned to it and it picks up the default return policy that we've created earlier. Now let's go back to our feed and configure this attribute. Let's go manage feed. Let's use this that we already have. United States is great. XML, USD, everything looks great. Let's go add a new attribute. The attribute we're looking for is the return policy. Let's see if we can find it. There we go, return policy label. Let's click on that, use an attribute, and find the attribute that you've just created. There we go, return labels. Let's update and generate this feed. Now let's go ahead and take a look at this feed. Let's scroll down and find the attribute. There we go, return policy. It's returning no return as expected. Let's see if we can find shoes. There we go, heels. And it's giving us quick return. So the return policy label and the dynamic attribute that we have created are working as expected. Let's go back to our Google Merchant Center and upload this feed. I have just uploaded the feed onto Google Merchant Center. Let's see if all the products are coming across as expected. So let's click on all products, men's brief. Let's scroll down and look at the attributes. There we go. Return policy is showing no return. Let's look at one more. Let's look at the heels, which has the category of shoes. Let's scroll down. As you can see, it's showing quick return. Perfect. Now it's time to go ahead and create the exceptions. So I'll go back to shipping and return, return policies. And under the return policy that we've already created, I'm going to add an exception. Click on add an exception. First, let's go ahead and set up the exception for underwears, which is for no return. So on the summary, we've got country is fine, United States, URL is good as well. This needs to change. I'll change this from yes, I accept returns to no, I do not accept returns. Click on next. Now let's go ahead and add the label we have created in our site, which is no return. Cool, there we go. The label is set and ready to go. Let's click on done. Voila, our exception is ready. Now let's go ahead and add the second exception. Click on the button again. United States is fine. URL is great. Yes, we do accept returns. Return method is in store. The return window is something I'd want to change. Instead of having 14 days, I want to shorten this and change it to 7 days. Let's go click next. Needs to be new, which is okay. And for restocking fee and shipping return and customer remorse, I'll keep it as it used to be. Let's click on next. Right here, I'll be able to add the label. The label I added for my shoes was quick return, so I'll add that here. Let's click on next. Click on done. There we go. As you can see, we have a return policy here. And we have two exceptions with labels set up right here. There you go, guys. Now you know how to configure return policies in Google Merchant Center. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.